Hey guys, Crispy Bacon back with another build video. This video is going to focus around a PvP Warlock build that I call Blood Raven. If you're looking for a new build for Trials when it comes out next season, then this is going to be the perfect build for you. The necessary pieces of equipment for this setup are going to be the Bastion Exotic Kinetic Fusion Rifle, as well as the Sanguine Alchemy Exotic Warlock Chest. I also have a secondary setup that uses the Vigilance Wing instead of Bastion, but we'll talk a bit more about that later. Check the timestamps in the description to make sure that you're listening to the most relevant information for you. The key aspect of this build is that we're going to have the most useful rifts that you can have inside of PvP. Rifts are extremely underused and underrated in PvP activities, and this build seeks to get Warlocks to use them more by highlighting all of the benefits you can have as long as you combo them right. With this build, our rifts will last longer and give us super energy, let us see enemies through walls, let us keep our radar while aiming down sights, empower our weapon damage and range as well as our allies, give everyone on our team what is essentially a shoulder-mounted turret, and recharge faster as long as we're staying near our allies. If you can find me a more useful rift for PvP activities, I'd love to hear it, but I really think that this one may take the cake. The other real benefit of this setup is that we're going to be able to take down any Guardian in their super from 100 to 0 with just one special ammo. There are a lot of moving parts and mods for this build, but let's start simple and talk about the weapons that we're using. First off is Bastion, a kinetic exotic fusion rifle that you can actually acquire just by speaking with Saint 14 and doing a quick quest for him. This fusion rifle is different from most in that it fires three spreads of kinetic slugs that break through enemy shields. This fusion rifle is a solid choice in PvP, but its most useful effect is that it can really tear through Guardian shields while they're in their super because of its exotic perk. In terms of how much damage it deals, it really feels like a Lord of Wolves in the primary slot, which is really nice in case you wanted to free up that energy slot for something else. It's got one of the shorter range drop-offs of all the fusion rifles, but if you're within that intended range of use, you're really going to tear down anything that's in your way in PvP. In your energy slot, you can really use whatever weapon you're comfortable with. I happen to be using Not Forgotten, just since it's one of my favorite high tier hand cannons. It doesn't have the best range, considering all hand cannons got a range nerf recently, but the empowering rift that we'll talk about later helps to boost that up just a bit. As for your heavy slot, again, same thing as the energy, you can use whatever you're comfortable with. I happen to be using Wendigo, just because it's a decent grenade launcher, and when it blinds enemies, they really have no chance of fighting back, so that's just another benefit itself. So now we come to the most important part of the build, the piece of equipment that really makes our playstyle, and that is the Sanguine Alchemy Exotic Warlock Chest. This armor piece can be found from any exotic drop source in the game, and its exotic perk allows us to, while we're standing in our rift, see enemies through walls, as well as keep our radar while we're aiming down sights. And I mean, come on, this thing's gotta get a few bonus points for just being one of the coolest exotic chests in the game. I mean, look at this thing, there's like a pool of blood on the back, and that blood runs through these wires into the front. Come on, that's awesome. But hey, that's neither here nor there. Let's talk about why this exotic is so good. This gives everyone on your team the ability to see through walls, see enemies through walls, that is, regardless of if they're invisible or in their super or what. Now, you all do have to be standing in your rift, and there is a limited range on how far you can see, but the range is pretty substantial. Being able to see every enemy and not just an enemy that shot you like One-Eyed Mask or the enemy that you shot like the Foe Tracer really makes this one stand out. This is a seriously useful function, especially for any high-level competitive PvP activities like Trials or Comp, where callouts are really the most important thing that you can have on a good team. Being able to read flanks properly or be prepared for an aggressive push from the enemy team is really something that's going to make or break a win. So the rest of this build intends to capitalize on the fact that we want to be in our rift as much as possible, and we want our rift to do as much for us as possible while we're in it. So the first thing that I want to mention is this synergy with fusion rifles. The weakness of fusion rifles is that you need to be able to charge up the weapon before firing, so you always need to have some sort of foresight. Well, what the Sanguine Alchemy does is removes that need for foresight. Since you can see enemies through walls, you know when they're going to appear out of cover. So what you can do is stay in cover, charge up your rifle, and then pop out right when the fusion rifle is ready to fire, and you already know that that enemy is going to be there. So this build is all about fusion rifles and rifts, so our stats and our mods are going to make sure that we prioritize these two and make them as proficient as possible. For our stats, we'll want to prioritize mobility and recovery, being an interesting one in this case because it actually allows our rift to generate faster, and that's going to obviously benefit us. As for the mods for this set, things get a bit interesting. For my helmet, I'm actually using a pre-armor 2.0 helmet because it's giving me light reactor and fusion rifle reserves. Both of these perks can be found on armor 2.0 mods, but in this case this was just the best way for me to set it up, but for you it might be different. Both of these perks are great though. Light reactor to give us more super energy whenever we get fusion rifle kills, and fusion rifle reserves giving us more fusion rifle ammo whenever we pick up ammo. For the arms, we're keeping it simple, using a mobility mod to help increase our mobility, and the enhanced rifle loader perk from this season's artifact. On the Sanguine Alchemy, I have the unflinching hand cannon aim to help out my Not Forgotten, and the enhanced unflinching rifle aim to help with my Bastion. On my legs, we've got a mobility mod and a fusion rifle dexterity and scavenger mod. And then on our bond, we've got a mobility mod, as well as two very useful mods, the perpetuation armor mod and the distribution armor mod. Perpetuation makes it so that when we use our rift, we actually get a faster cooldown towards our next rift. And then distribution makes it so that when we use our rift, it actually reduces the cooldown of our melee, our grenade, and our super ability. Now this is a great combo because we want to use our rift all the time, and we will be, and this means that every time we use it, we'll be reducing all of our other cooldowns, including our super. It was seriously noticeable that I would get my super before everyone else on my team, and it was all thanks to the perpetuation and distribution. Combo this with light reactor from all of our fusion rifle kills, and we are getting our super very quickly. Now we've talked about a lot of great synergies here, and already this build is very useful, but now it's time to put the icing on the cake and see how it all comes together. It's really the subclass that we're using with this setup that takes the already great build and enhances each individual element even further. We'll be using Bottom Tree Stormcaller with the Attunement of Elements perk tree. For the grenades and jump, you can use whatever you're comfortable with, but as for the rifts, what I recommend is using Empowering Rift when you're feeling confident you're playing against a team that you can really compete with, but when you feel like things aren't quite going your way, maybe switch over to Healing Rift to make sure you have a defensive option. So as for our perk tree, our first perk is going to be Rising Storm. This electrocuting melee hits at an extended range and recharges your super, grenade, and melee. Now this additional range should not be underestimated, and the fact that it recharges our super, grenade, and melee all at the same time is really beneficial, especially with the already strong super gain that we have. Next is Landfall. On casting Storm Trance, fire a bolt of lightning into the ground, creating a devastating shockwave under you. You can think of this like a Fist of Havoc at the beginning of your super activation. If there are any enemies surrounding you, you can activate this and kind of wipe everybody out immediately before you go on your rampage. What's nice is that you can activate this mid-air, and the lightning bolt will kind of travel infinitely down towards the ground, so it doesn't matter how high up you are, and you can take enemies by surprise by just activating your super way up high in the air as long as you're above them. Next is Arc Soul. Your rift now grants you or any ally that uses it an Arc Soul to aid in battle. Arc Souls tend to be underrated by most, and I'd really urge you not to do so. The extra damage that Arc Souls provide to any engagement really comes in handy, and it can even shoot enemies that you aren't directly engaging with or aiming at, which helps you secure kills more easily. And if you think about it, with an entire team of Arc Soul wielding guardians, you essentially have an extra player on your side when you think about all of those arc bolts flying at your enemy team. And lastly, the perk that brings it all together is Electrostatic Surge. Your rift lasts longer, and it charges faster when allies are near. This perk really is what brings this entire build together. It makes it so that as long as you're playing as a team, as long as you're playing cooperatively, properly, sticking together, and focusing down your targets together, that your rift will almost always be up. And since we know how beneficial our rift is going to be with this setup, this is really the perk that we needed to make this work out. I found this perk very useful both because obviously you get your rift much faster while you're sticking with your teammates, but also it kind of forced me to play with my teammates. Usually I have a problem of going off on my own and getting killed and team wiped by the other team, but this perk made it so that there was actually a benefit to sticking with my own team, which both allowed me to give my teammates good benefits because of Sanguine Alchemy and all of the benefits that we've mentioned, but also let me play better as an individual player because it forced me to play as a teammate. If Bastion just is not your thing, or you have a special weapon that you want to use in the energy slot instead, I'd say Vigilance Wing is the next best bet. This is because, on top of being a very solid pulse rifle in general, this is really one of the perfect weapons for high-level competitive play. And that's because it actually gains benefits when you're playing in a smaller team. Its perk Last Stand improves weapon performance and greatly increases recovery when its wielder is the last living member of a fire team. Now this is awesome when it comes to like clutching out a last man standing scenario where you're the last teammate alive and you have to fight one or two members of the opposing team. But the great thing that we're actually looking for here is greatly increased recovery when its wielder is the last living member of a fire team. So earlier we had talked about how your recovery stat actually determines your rift regeneration speed. Well, this last stand perk actually gives you max recovery whenever you're the last living member of a fire team. And this means that when you're the only one left, you're actually going to be regaining your rift much faster than normal. And this is great considering we have many different things that are helping us get our rift faster, and this is just kind of the icing on the cake in that case. And in addition, you have the perk Harsh Truths. This weapon fires a 5-round burst. When a nearby ally is killed, gain health regeneration and increase movement speed. This is great since anytime a team member dies, we'll actually start healing and moving quickly. And this is great when using Empowering Rift, because we don't have the healing power of the Healing Rift, and this kind of supplements that. Anytime a teammate dies, you'll start healing right away, and it feels really good to have on. With the Vigilance Wing, I would still recommend comboing it with a Fusion Rifle in the energy slot, since Fusion Rifles really have a good synergy with this build. I might even recommend Air Intel with this setup, since it's already got ridiculously long range, and when you combo that with the extra damage and range from Empowering Rift, it's just gonna make those cross-map one-shot kills that much easier. But hey guys, that will about do it for this build. So I hope that this enlightened you all on the benefits of Warlocks in PvP. I hope to see more of you out there playing Warlock because they are very underrated and underrepresented. If you want more from me, check the description to see all the places that you can get in contact with me and the community. But as always, thank you so much for watching and have a good one.
We thank you, Guardian, and we will never forget.